Students, let us continue after the break. Yes, my dear students, framing a sentence using infinite, that is 2+V1, don't scare. Infinite means the preposition 2+V1. V1 means the verb base form. Root form of the verb is known as V1. 2+V1 is known as infinite. Just now we learnt a gerund is used as subject or object. Likewise, we can also use infinite as subject or object in place of gerund. Instead of gerund, we can use 2+V1, that is infinite, or we can also call an infinite also called non-finite. Non-finite, that is also called 2+V1. So, 2+V1 is not a complete verb. Non-finite means work is not completed, yet to do. When we use 2+V1, it means yet to complete. So, how to use infinite or non-finite, that is 2+V1 in a sentence? Let us see some examples. Examples of infinite as subject. Now the following examples. Describe how 2+V1, an infinite or non-finite, used as subject to get, to build, to drive, to become. To get means have not got, yet to get. To get a bank job is my ambition. What is my ambition? Come on, say. To become, to get a bank job is my ambition. Is the verb. My ambition is object. So, what is subject? To get a bank job. To get a bank job is the subject. Next, to build a house is his desire. What is his desire? To build a house. He didn't build yet. He wants to build. When he wants to build, we say to build. To build a house is his desire. Desire means a strong liking. To drive, you see here, to drive a car is my brother's hobby. What is my brother's hobby? To drive a car. His hobby is not yet completed. He wants to drive a car, yet to drive a car. Next, to become, not became, to become an IPS officer is my goal. You see, what a wonderful goal. What is my goal? To become an IPS officer, a police officer is my goal. So in these examples, we used infinite or non-finite or 2 plus V1 as subjects. Okay, sentence. So in framing a sentence, infinite can be used as subject or object. These are examples of infinite as subject. Now let us see examples of infinite as object. We can also use infinite or non-finite as object of a sentence. Other examples of infinite as object. My ambition is the subject. Is the verb. What is object? To get a bank job. To get a bank job is an objective case. I like to play cricket. What I like to play? I like to play cricket. I is the subject. Like is the verb. To play cricket is object. Very simple. Concentration is the key for understanding. Tough grammar. Listen. Don't divert your mind. Concentrate. Look at the board, listen my words, then you can easily get scoring in grammar part. So, I like to play cricket. What I like to play? Cricket. Rita loves to wear a gold chain. You see, girls, ladies like gold very much. So, Rita is the subject, loves is the verb, to wear a gold chain. To wear what? A gold chain. Rita loves. So, this is object. Infinite is used in object with the complement. Gold chain is the complement of the object. His desire. What is his desire? So his desire is subject. Is the verb to buy a new car. See, different desires, different likings. So his desire is to buy a new car. My brother's goal is the subject. Is the verb. What is my goal? To get IAS. Oh, very strong desire. His goal is very high. But you must try. So, my brother's goal is to get IAS. So, in these examples, infinite used as subject. In these examples, infinite is used as object. See, these are the infinites or non-finites, or we can say 2 plus V1 can be used as subject or object. In the next class, let us know the terms and conditions, the rules and regulations, where to use gerund, where not to use gerund. Likewise, where to use infinite, that is non-finite, that is 2 plus V1, where not to use infinite. That let us continue, because it is a critical topic. You can't understand at a time. So tomorrow, let us learn the rules using a gerund and infinite. Thank you. Thank you very much.